Hello and welcome to Christian Labor. Please like, subscribe, comment, click on an ad, or donate from the banner of our YouTube homepage. Thank you. Here we are at Suno, shortly after the battle of the previous engagement. Thought I would take a little time to do a recap. Here is our tiny little warband. This is why I'm trying to get money so I can support a warband that can actually do some raiding. Something I noticed about myself last time is my power draw is zero, which would help explain why when I shoot people it does no damage, especially if they've got a lot of armor. Here I am with Moraga. I have been pretending that Moraga had a crossbow. Moraga does not have a crossbow. Moraga has a gun. So, unfortunately, that means I have been... I don't know, this is crazy. See, I was actually amping up her archery and not her firearms. Archery, by the way, is not the same as crossbow, which is what I thought she had. So I wasted several points on her. I'm probably going to make her scout. Work on pathfinding, tracking, make the band a little bit faster, able to see further, and eventually able to track down foes. And wanted to show you here strength, see the skills or whatever that each of these main attributes controls. This game has some other skills as well, so they don't show up in the list. And you end up having to guess what they work off of. It's usually self-explanatory, though. Again, here's our little warband. Here we are in Suno. Let's go with a little bit more Fantasy Calradia. Oh, hello! How are you there, traveler? Wandering a sheep. No time for you today. What's your name?
Hello there. My name's Clay. You look like a scrapper.
I might be, I might. What's your story?
Well, sir, as long as I can remember, I've been getting in trouble because I'm a ratty little thief.
You don't look much like a hobbit.
But I could use a burglar.
You're hired! Oh, dear. Proof that God loves us.
Cleety, 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 or Clethy, as normal folks would probably refer to her, has a great deal of stealth, which means if she hits somebody from behind with a stealth weapon, she gets some kind of bonus that I don't know how it works because I've never made a stealth character using this mod. I imagine the thing to do is to get a lot of movement and stealth and then kind of flank people, you know, move around them and smack them in the back. But anyway, I like to put her here in the what I like to call baggage because she has no armor. So I like to try and remember to put those guys way back in the back somewhere. Hopefully I'll remember. Sometimes I don't.
Oh well.
So, me and the lads and the two little lassies, leaving out a proven, find a lawless elven warband attacking a defenseless lot of wizards. Well, as it turned out, they were a little bit more defenseless than you might have thought, so I decided to give them a hand. Well, their boys just ran off ahead without us. You know me, I kind of like to set up a little defensive arrangement on the hilltop any chance I get, so I just kind of let them run off without us and set up a little defensive arrangement on this hilltop, like I like to do. I noticed they left me a couple of golems. It's kind of confusing. I get to looking at them and I'm like, none of these boys are mine! Maybe those elven archers, I'm not sure, but you can kind of look through the trees and see. Apparently all the Kerevan Guard got themselves killed, sure enough. I thought I'd go out to the side and try a little flanking maneuver on my own. Got my archers to go ahead and fire.
I got one! A couple of them with my horse. Killed that one.
Ooh.
Missed that fella. You see the stragglers, they slowly work their way up, and then the boys in the front just pick them off.
That
it's a pretty good strategy. Get myself stuck here. And then I get my horse knocked down here. And then I get myself knocked down here. And in the haze of my bleeding forehead, staring up at the combat, I realize I might be able to raise my voice to get a retreat going. Crawl away. This fella comes in along with some reinforcements. I'm thinking to myself, self, maybe I'm not going to die after all. See, further golem reinforcements, but their elves are just standing off, picking us off, so sure enough I'm able to get a retreat called. Crawled away myself and back behind the lines, and then organized for another charge. Now that I understand what's going on, pretty sure we've got it made. It's all they have is those wimpy little archers left. So as soon as we get them in range, I'll just send the infantry down to clean them up. But I'd got myself knocked unconscious before I gave the charge order, so no one was going to charge. They were just going to sit there and get themselves shot to hell. Ah, you see him coming in the distance. Built myself up. Wasn't feeling too good after that beatdown. No. But there are certain advantages to being blessed by the Lord. I don't necessarily wait for them to see the whites of their eyes before I send in the charge, but I like to get them at least close enough to where I don't have them out of range of my own archers. And I don't know how many times I'm going to have to mention this, but once I get a better horse, things will be much more entertaining. I didn't manage to come around and flank this fella. I mean, this fella. There he goes. No, as a matter of fact, I didn't hurt him either, did I? That fella. I got that fella. And that's the only one. And we win. See, not so bad once you know what you're doing. So there are the regrettable casualties one Nord shot. Made a friend in the ride of Smejacracy. Sure, he'll give me a little good word to the Archmage, and of course I train up all my men and take these captives, because they're worth money. Maraga found a pair of boobs she liked. She's always off somewhere taking target practice, and she's gonna be a fine sharpshooter one day. Woe unto the man that does her wrong, though. Anyway, thought it best to let her have those boots. Since we were up close to the Dwarven Kingdoms anyway, I decided to recruit some of my Dwarven mates for my band. No finer infantry in all of Calradia. But I do catch a little ribbon because I prefer Elven archers to Dwarven sharpshooters. Oh sure, the Dwarven rifles penetrate the armor much more effectively, but those Elven archers can shoot 3-4 times more quickly, and their bodkins penetrate armor well enough. Plus their aim's so good half the time they hit a man in the eyeball anyway, and what difference does armor make then? So, I came to the town Yargr, looking for a few good men. But instead it was festooned with bandits. Set myself my men down in this little valley between these two hills, and my archers up here on this hill. Simple defensive. Not much to it. For some reason, Cleethy ran off ahead. I know her in her sneaky ways, so I thought she was going to reconnoiter the enemy. But I never really heard from her again. Not long after that, they come up over the hilltop. I probably could have just sat down here and let the archers take them out one by one. But I decided to give the peasants here a little lesson on how to take care of themselves. Often enough, I'm not going to be around to help them, so they need to learn to defend their own territory. I see that with just a little bit of leadership, they actually make a pretty decent fighting crew. But these bandits are deserters from professional military outfits. Look at them, overwhelming them, beating them to a pulp. Last man standing was down here. Turned out to be a little trouble for me. I took his first arrow in my shield. Missed him there. He lit into me with his axe, and I was able to block most of his blows. Eventually, he was just overwhelmed. I slash him across the skull with my cleaver. That was the end of him. So, Alathir, somebody made up a little bit of a makeup elvish. It's a long story. Blah, blah, blah. Sometimes there's not a lot of honor, even in hunting bandits, chasing down some of these looters. I'm thinking to myself, they probably end up out here out of desperation, even starvation. No armor, hardly any weapons to speak of. Still, can't leave them out here preying on innocent folk either. In the end, a man has to have the courage to stand up even to the evils that life brings to us without turning into a beast ourselves. The holy scriptures of the dwarves say, do whatever it is that your hand finds to do, but do it, it's unto the Lord. But as I'm out here crushing these skulls and watching the lifeblood run out of these poor bastards, I can't help but also think of another holy scripture. Live by the sword, die by the sword. Finally remember to put a little power draw on him. Bump up the charisma a little bit. Ready to hit the faith again. Practice archery. And if you're not familiar with the game, what happens with this training skill is anyone lower level is trained by anyone upper level. And that includes all of your soldiers. So it becomes very important later in the game because you need your more powerful soldiers, but they get killed and you need to train them back up more quickly. But that's just how that works. Thought I'd explain it real fast. Skeletons. Oh, aye. All over the world. Skeletons and shadows. Shadows and skeletons, and of course, the occasional zombie. Well, I sent the unarmed back towards the baggage, the infantry towards the front, archers to the rear as always. As always in these early days, before I learned to set the infantry to the side. Here you see, we've got this one young cavalryman. He does us a good job. I'll set him off to the side there, thinking I could flank him with him a bit. They always do better on the charge, these cavalrymen. And the younger ones there, men-at-arms. Well, their armor's not all that good. Speaking of armor that's not all that good, at this stage of my career, mine wasn't the best either. Look at that fella! He's chasing him back. Oh, this is what you're supposed to learn not to do in your old age. Don't overextend yourself. Oh, this little bastard. Look at those poor archers. Miss, miss, miss. And then he gets his clock knocked off. That young man goes far in the ranks. It was about this time that I met Jeremus. Jeremus was a drinking monk, just the kind I like. He had a long story, but to make it short, Jeremus had a large mind and a large mouth, and his mouth got him into trouble sometimes. Not entirely unlike Bunduk. I decided to try and arm Jeremus just a touch, but I didn't have much on me. As we talked, it turned out that he's quite the surgeon and a more than adequate healer. And not insubstantial in his faith, and, well, not entirely adequate at all in combat skills. But that's something we could teach him. I decided to set him back with the baggage as well. There's nothing quite as irritating as a sanctimonious fundamentalist. These are folk that put on the airs of honor and tradition, but then turn right around and use it to steal, maim, and murder. Naturally, I wasn't gonna put up with that. We had them well outnumbered too. Always handy to be on a hillside. Sent my cavalry out to the side there. Scouts let me know that I had set him more or less straight ahead, so I had to set him a little bit back further there. And shortly here you'll see, they crest the hill just as I'm forming up me men. There they go. Drew him back just a little. There they come, there they come. See, they're chasing him down already. Just to the left of the hillock. One of them running away. Finds his courage and comes back towards us. And I charge the men in. See, this time I set my horseman way out to the side there so he doesn't get in my way. But of course I miss, and I miss, and I miss. I swear it gets better someday. I do believe I said after 12 or 15 more battles. No sense letting a coward get away. That'll have to do.
You smell that fresh air, brother? This was my home before I went abroad in search of coin. It's good to be up in the hills again, smell of freedom. This is a cradle of road arc liberty, here on the Grunwalder Castle. In my father's day, the Swadians would come calling, thinking to make us knuckle our foreheads and call him their overlords. But Grunwalder, an old veteran of the wars from the hills, showed us how to form a battle line with spear and crossbow that could break the Swadian charge. He fell in battle, but the people gave his name to the castle that was built here, where he fell, so that we would remember and always stand firm against the horseman's onslaught. We go, mulberry trees here for silk, caramel stew for the dye. Take it to Jill Collar, where they weave it into the finest velvet. Not that I ever had enough dinars in my pocket to buy velvet, mind. But the craftsmen of Jill Collar also make good crossbows, and for that I'll not begrudge them their little luxuries.
In the early days of Durin's fame, the Blazing Hand held sway in the northeast of Calradia, whereas the Orcs had conquered the eastern steppes that had once been ruled by the Kurgan Khanate. To the southeast of Nara, the Kurgan's new capital, the Dark Elves had breached the surface of the earth, and also to the west of the Saranid Empire for reasons best known only to them. Finally, Jill Collar found itself wrested from the Rodok kingdoms by the Rydus Magocracy, which had long maintained influence in the region from their wizard's tower along the western coasts.
We were travelling in great haste on a Monday, along an icky trail full of zombies. I met a strange lady. She made me nervous. We didn't really have time for breakfast.
Aye, you lads, get back there, back there! You, back I said. How many times do I have to tell you? Ah, you, that way, way over there. Don't poke me with that spear. Watch what you're doing, watch what you're doing! That's it now. Oh, they're on us, lads, already. That's it. Hold it. Hold the lines. Now bunch yourselves up. In ranks, in ranks. Up, charge, you crazy nimwits. Didn't you see them sneaking up on you? Yes. Ah, fuck. What are you doing here? You don't look dead. You're not dead yet. Have you killed my horse? Well, you paid for that, didn't you? Ah, oh, bless you all, bless you all! Now I've got you, now I've got you! Death, the zombies! You are doomed! Again! Seriously, how did you get in this kind of shit anyway? All for the blessings of the good Lord on all of you. Let's get the last one. Can't even see it. And what are these zombies doing out in the sunlight anyway? Aren't they supposed to, like, turn to jelly or something like that? Would you get out of the way? Ah, there he is. I'll take him. Leave him to me, lads. Leave him to me. I know how to handle this sort. That's right, come to Papa, come to Papa! What kind of a zombie shoots a crossbow anyway? You're not a zombie either! Crazy, did you? You shot my zombie! Oh, now you're gonna laugh at me. Yeah, you'll think it's funny when you see your rations after this battle.
They say that the Shadow Wizard has more loneliness than any man could bear. Oh, I guess we'll have to slaughter him before he falls into despair. I am a poet and I didn't know it. But my feet short cause they're short, fellas. Oh, yes. What do you mean you don't get it? So this time around, I thought I'd experiment with lining up the archers to the right and the soldiers to the left. Now who is casting that firestorm, but it looks pretty effective. Bound to be one of the elves. I experiment with this, but I get it all wrong, largely because these shadows get to me before I really thought they could. So naturally, they foul up my archer lines. But it's okay, because out where you can't really see, the infantry is holding its own. Cavalry, come over here and saves archers from being too badly hurt. Good work there, man, good work. So I draw the archers up here so they can help finish off the remainder. But really, even as bad as my positioning was, there's not a whole lot needing to be done here. I do recommend stone golems highly. Prayers, study, and meditation. Build faith and wisdom. And I practice my archery regularly. Because I don't want to go down in history as the worst dwarven archer ever. Woke up in my clothes again this morning. Not sure exactly where I am. Ugh. I should heed Jeremus's warning. He does the best with me he can. He claims I suffer from delusions. But I'm so confident and sane. It can't be an optical illusion. How do you explain these shadows in the rain? Ugh. Well, it was raining earlier. I have been known to beat a dead horse. They annoy me, twitching and sputtering like unfinished business. So I beat the damn dead horse till it stops. And then there it is, its corpse staring at me, accusingly. So I beat the damned corpse of the dead horse, mostly around the eyes till they're gone. But then the horses at it again, sitting there stinking, bloating and reeking. So I beat the dead corpse till the pulp of it sticks to the veins, popped from the arms by the stream. Beat the thing till it's nothing but an unhappy memory. A huge gory hole in the ground where my love used to be. Oh, come on now, that's an original! I know you're noticing a bit of a trend. Shadows and corpses. Corpses and shadows. I guess it's just that time of the year. There's a bit of a difficulty that I run into training these men at this point in time. If you notice, the Swedians like to train themselves up as infantrymen for a while. And then they shift themselves over to ride these horses, but they don't put any armor on the horse at first. And they get themselves killed pretty regularly that way. And I didn't really quite know how to handle that until a few battles later. Look at my men killing all these extra horses that belong to the enemy. I had to give them an order to stop doing that. That's a waste of horse flesh. Horse flesh is good eating. There's one of the great warriors of all time, one of the Swedian knights of the king. He ends up getting killed somewhere, but I don't rightly remember where. But I'll be sure to note it for you. Well, there's one more band of the little buggers. Larger band than the others, really, but I'm feeling kinda froggy, so I jump on them. I run all my horses into my infantry, and all my archers into my cavalry, and only get those boys stuck. So there you see, I've actually got a senior mage, which is where all the fireworks keep coming from. There the cavalry goes into the infantry again, but I guess since I finally just got tired of trying to organize it and charge. Got that fella. Then that fella got my horse. And then they firebombed me, so I feel like I ought to heal my men up a bit. And then I go off this direction thinking I'm gonna flank somebody and ooh! Just see those elven archers! You got to love that eyeball shot! Oh, love those! Get over here, and I miss, and I miss, and I miss! I finally slaughtered that dead man! Get a little shot in on that dead man! And really, at some point, I guess I just kind of forget I even have that bow and arrow on my back. It hardly matters, I can't hit nothing with it anyway. Are you sure you want to retreat? Hell no, I don't want to retreat, I just won the battle! What kind of a ridiculous question is that? Heh, 2 killed. Where is Jeremus?
Thanks again for watching Christian Labor. Please like, subscribe, comment, click on an ad, or donate from the banner of our YouTube homepage. Thank you very much.